My name's Hannah Cloke, and I'm from the University of Reading. Last year's flooding here in the UK again brought home the enormous social and economic impacts of flooding. I'm interested in developing techniques to help us prepare better for flooding by improving forecasting, particularly of severe flood events.
So here's the soil moisture, and we can see that it's very blue, which means it's very wet. It's been quite a lot of rain across these parts of Europe.
So that we can predict floods, we need to know when and where it will rain, or when the snow is melting, and how this water moves through and under the landscape to rivers and eventually downstream to places where people live and work. But not only is rainfall and snowmelt very difficult to forecast, the landscape around us is incredibly complex. And this means that even our best scientific equations cannot always accurately predict when and where it will flood and how big that flood will be. My research looks at how we can use flood forecasts based on the likelihood they will happen, the probability.
So we've got some points here flagged up with possibility of flooding here.
And this is where we provide a whole range of predictions that can communicate the forecast uncertainty, so we can say which scenarios are most likely to happen and also understand what the worst case could be. This helps us to evaluate the risks and make more informed decisions about whether we should evacuate a whole village or shut a floodgate. I work closely with flood forecasters and industry partners to advance the design and practical application of flood forecasting and warning systems in the UK and internationally, such as the European Flood Awareness System.
This is the European Centre for Medium-Range Weather Forecasts, and here we do global weather forecasting. This is the home of the European Flood Awareness System, EFAS. Thanks to Hannah's contribution, EFAS is now an operational system that delivers early flood warnings to many authorities in Europe.
This work has had a real impact in that we are now better prepared for floods. And as we take these techniques forward, we could reduce flood risk to people across the world.